At the end of the topic, you will be able to identify the various reasons for the revolt of 1857. Recognize the British policies that instigated this revolt. Introduction. Indian people from all sections were unhappy with the administration of British in India. In the year 1857, a revolt broke out in India against the British rule. The immediate cause was the introduction of a new Enfield rifle. Its cartridge was greased with the fat of pigs and cows, which were refused by the Hindu and Muslim soldiers. This resulted in the Sepoy Mutiny in 1857. Mangal Pandey, an Indian soldier, killed a British officer for forcing him to use a rifle. Later, he was executed on 9th May 1857. This sparked the revolt of 1857 in India. Other reasons were invasion of Bengal by the British in 1757 and the doctrine of lapse introduced by Dalhousie. Indian cottage industries and handicrafts suffered a setback because of the British Industrial Revolution. Lastly, Indian culture and religious sentiments were hurt. The participants of the revolt were individual rulers, sepoys, and civilians. The British were shocked by this revolt of 1857 and called this revolt as the First War of Independence. Revolt of 1857. The revolt of 1857 was the most severe outburst of anger and discontent accumulated in the hearts of various sections of the Indian society. This revolt was supported by all sections of people. Hindus and Muslims kept their religious differences aside and fought together in order to free themselves from foreign subjugation. The Great Armed Rebellion, which took place in India in 1857, was called the First War of Independence. Political reasons. The British vigorously followed the policy of annexations, displacing the old ruling kingdoms. Sindh, Punjab, Jhansi and Audh kingdoms were annexed to British India. Lord Dalhousie, 1848-1856, the Governor General of India, promoted further annexations through many evil-designed steps. The doctrine of lapse was a brainchild of Lord Dalhousie. If the ruler had no children, there was a practice of adopting a son. Dalhousie declared that the adoption without permission by the British was not valid. The British refused to consent to the kings to adopt a child and annex their kingdoms. The ruling class and zamindars were displaced and the lands were taken by the British.
Political reasons. One of the main reasons for the revolt was the annexation policy. The British did not honor the subsidiary treaties signed with the Indian rulers. Satara, Nagpur and Jhansi were annexed. The Hindus resented this. The successor of Bahadur Shah II, the last Mughal emperor, was asked to hand over the palace and the Red Fort to the British on the death of the emperor. Nana Saheb was the adopted son of the Peshwa Baji Rao II. His pension was stopped and this enraged him. The policies of the British displeased the Muslims. They felt deprived of their political power. Administrative reasons. British administration was not liked or trusted by the Indians. They were not in favor of the introduction of English as the official language instead of Persian. Indians did not feel safe under the British. They feared that their property might be confiscated and that their lives would be in danger. Indians were taxed heavily. The landlords and peasants faced great difficulties due to this taxation. Indians were not given high posts either in civilian or military administration. Educated Indians were deprived of good jobs.
Economic reasons. One of the main reasons for the revolt in 1857 was the economic exploitation of the British. The revenue policies of the British, such as permanent settlement and Rayatwari, brought in large-scale discontentment. The taxes were collected even during famines and droughts, whereas in earlier times, the native Rajas waived taxes during that period. With the advent of Industrial Revolution, the British established cotton textile industries in their country and took no measures to improve the agriculture in India. As a result, the British discouraged the cotton textile industry in India, and India was made as a market for its goods.
Social and religious reasons.
From 1813 AD, Christian missionaries entered into India with an intention to civilize the Indians by converting them as Christians. Abolition of sati, widow remarriage, and introduction of railways where people can travel together without any caste barriers were some of the impact of the missionaries. The Christian missionaries established schools for boys and girls in which teaching of the Bible was also compulsory. This made the Orthodox Hindus and Muslims to suspect the British attitude towards Indians. Muslim Maulvis also called a holy war against Christianity. Religious sentiments. British came to India with an intention of spreading Christianity. Indians were observing Tuesdays, Fridays, Full Moon Day and New Moon Day as inauspicious for shaving beards and to have their hair cut. The sepoys who were recruited into army were required to keep their beards clean every day and their hair very short. This hurt the beliefs of the Indians. Voyages also were prohibited for Indians, but the men who were recruited into the army were often sent out of our country by sea. All these things created a fear among Indians of loss of their religion and caste.
Military causes. The Indian sepoys were not happy under British administration. The Indians were paid very much less than the British soldiers. The Subedar, the highest rank among the Indian soldiers, were paid less than the lowest ranked British soldier. Indian sepoys were treated badly and not given promotions. Under the General Services Enlistment Act, the Indian soldiers were asked to serve outside India. The act was passed by Lord Canning in 1856 and was resented by the Indians. Indian soldiers outnumbered the British soldiers almost fivefold. This encouraged the Indians to stand up against the British. Moreover, important cities like Delhi and Allahabad was under Indian soldiers.
Immediate causes.
The major part of the British army in India was composed of Indians. They formed 7/8 of the total of the government troops in India. All the higher posts were reserved for the English, and a great disparity arose between the salaries of Indian and European soldiers. The introduction of the new rifle, called Enfield rifle, created further discontentment among the soldiers. The cartridges of these rifles were smeared with the fat of cows and pigs as grease, and the paper covering them had to be bitten off before they could be loaded into the rifles. The Muslims had hatred towards pigs, and Hindus had devotion to cows. So, the Hindu and Muslim soldiers refused to accept the greased cartridges. The British punished those Indian soldiers who refused to use the rifles, and this incident sparked the revolt of 1857 in India.
Mangal Pandey. Mangal Pandey was a young sepoy from the Bengal regiment. He refused to use the Enfield rifles as they were greased with animal fat. On 29th March 1857, in a place called Barakpur near Calcutta, Pandey attacked a British officer who forced him to use the rifle. Pandey was immediately arrested and later hanged on 8 April 1857. As the news of Pandey's hanging spread, a revolt broke out against the British all over India.
In this topic you have learnt the Great Armed Rebellion, which took place in India in 1857, was called the First War of Independence. The revolt of 1857 in India was due to common aversion among Indian people against the British rule in India. The doctrine of lapse was introduced by Dalhousie as a major instrument of annexation. Agriculture suffered a major setback with the British rule. The British punished those Indian soldiers for refusing to use the Enfield rifles, and this incident sparked the revolt of 1857 in India.
At the end of the topic, you will be able to identify the regions where the revolt broke out, list the important leaders of the revolt, discuss the manner in which the revolt was suppressed by the British.
On 23rd January 1857, at Dum Dum, the revolt against the British started. Again, in February 1857, the infantry at Berampur revolted against the British by refusing to accept the greased cartridges. On 29th March at Barakpur, Mangal Pandey, a soldier, killed a British lieutenant as he compelled him to accept the cartridge greased with the fat of pigs and cows. Later, Mangal Pandey was executed on 9th May 1857. About 85 Indian soldiers were sentenced to long periods of imprisonment for revolting. This revolt spread like wildfire to many parts of India. Uproars felt in different parts of India. Delhi was captured by the rebels. Bahadur Shah II, the Mughal heir, was proclaimed as Emperor of India. He was residing at Red Fort at that time. The revolt spread to Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Orissa, Bihar, Assam, Rajasthan, and Sindh provinces. There was chaos and panic everywhere. The revolt was confined to army barracks. The British controlled the revolt by disarming the Indian sepoys.
Spread of the revolt. In May 1857, there was an open revolt by the sepoys in Meerut. Prisons were broken and sepoys who were imprisoned were set free. Gradually, the revolt spread to Lucknow, Bareilly, Kanpur, Agra, Jhansi, Benares, Bandelkhand, and central India. Kanpur, Delhi, and Lucknow were the three main cities where the revolt was centered. Rani Lakshmibai, Tantia Tope, Nana Sahib, and Kunwar Singh were prominent leaders involved in the revolt.
Peshwa Baji Rao adopted Nana Sahib as his son. The title Peshwa means noble Maratha prince. In Kanpur, Nana Sahib was initially in favor of the British, but later attacked a British group that took refuge in the southern part of Kanpur. Nana Sahib fired and bombarded the group held by General Wheeler in 1857, and the British suffered severe loss. The British were offered a choice to flee at Sati Chaura Ghat off the Ganges River, and it resulted in a failure due to conspiracy, and both the sides fired. This incident is called Sati Chaura Massacre. British women and children were taken under Nana Sahib's custody. Later, even they were killed in the Bibi Gar massacre. The British forces reached Kanpur on July 16, 1857, and set Nana Sahib's house on fire. Nana Sahib was proclaimed as the Peshwa and his succession was suspended by the British. Nana Sahib fled to Nepal and passed away in the year 1906.
Revolt in Delhi and Lucknow. Delhi came under the control of the rebels in 1857. The revolt was suppressed by Sir Arkdale Wilson, Nicholson, and Sir John Lawrence. British soldiers killed Indians ruthlessly. The Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah II was accused of treason and exiled to Rangoon. In Lucknow, the rebels killed Sir Lawrence and Colonel Neil. They were chief commissioners of the British Army. Begum Hasrat Mahal, wife of the Nawab of Oudh, actively took part in the revolt. In March 1858, The revolt in Lucknow was suppressed by Sir Colin Campbell.
Rani Lakshmi Bai. Rani Lakshmi Bai was a talented queen and she revolted against the British when she was not allowed to adopt a son to inherit her kingdom after her husband's death in 1854. So, in Jhansi, Rani Lakshmi Bai was proclaimed as the ruler and she sent the troops to the battlefield. She joined hands with Maulvi and Nana Sahib in 1857 revolt against the British. Tantia Top. Tantia Top's father was a noble at the court of Maratha Peshwa Baji Rao. Tantia Top developed friendship with Nana Sahib, the adopted son of Peshwa. Tantia Top was a close associate of Nana Sahib in the freedom struggle and led the army in 1858 against the British. Kunwar Singh belonged to the Rajput noble family and was born in Jagdishpur. When the revolt of 1857 broke out, Kunwar Singh was 80 years old, yet he fought against the British forces. Kunwar Singh led the rebels in Bihar and freed some parts of Bihar. He then proceeded to help their counterparts in Lucknow and Kanpur. He passed away after fighting against the British for a year on April 23, 1858. To honour his contributions in India's freedom struggle, the Republic of India issued stamps in memory of Kunwar Singh on 23rd April 1966, suppression of the revolt. In September 1857, Delhi was recaptured by the British. Bahadur Shah was taken as a prisoner and was sent to Rangoon in Burma, where he died in 1862. His three sons were captured and shot dead by the British. Aud was recaptured by the British in September 1858. Throughout the revolt, Hindus and Muslims worked together.
At the end of the topic, you will be able to analyze the causes for the failure of the revolt, discuss the results of the revolt, give details of Queen Victoria's proclamation, list the Indian leaders of the revolt. Introduction. In 1857, a major revolt broke out in India. The people of India revolted against the rule of the British East India Company. There were several causes for the outbreak of the revolt, which spread across many parts of India. The revolt was ultimately suppressed by the British. Main causes for the failure of the revolt. The main reason for the failure of the revolt was disunity among the Indians. The revolt was restricted to North India, Punjab, Sindh, Rajasthan, and regions in South India did not participate in the revolt. Zamindars and rulers of several Indian states did not take part in the revolt. They remained neutral. Educated Indians did not support the revolt.
Other causes for the failure of revolt. The British had a wide telegraph and postal communication network. This was very useful to get immediate information of any uprising by Indians anywhere in the country. They immediately sent forces to suppress the uprising. The weapons used by the revolting Indians were outdated and were no match to the modern weapons used by the British. British generals were far superior in warfare than Nana Sahib, Tantia Tope, and Rani Lakshmi Bai.
Telegraph. The telegraph is a machine for sending messages over a long distance. It uses electricity to send coded messages through wires. In the middle of the 1800s, the telegraph was the quickest way to send information over long distances. Modern means of communication are computers and cell phones. Events that led to the failure of the revolt. The revolt was actually planned to start on 31st May 1857 all over India, but it started much earlier, leaving Indians unprepared. This early outbreak of the revolt led to its failure. Indian leaders did not have the ability to plan and organize the revolt effectively. They were brave and dedicated but lacked direction. There was disunity among the Indians who revolted. The Muslims wanted to bring back Mughal rule, while the Hindus wanted the Peshwa Raj. The British used the strategy of divide and rule. They did not allow the Indian rulers to come together and fight against the British. Results of the revolt. The Great Revolt of 1857 was a failure for the Indians. The Government of India Act 1858 was passed. The administration of India was taken away from the company and India was now ruled directly by the British Crown. The office of the Secretary of State for India was formed. He was helped by an Indian council of 15 members. The Governor General was made the Viceroy of India. The Viceroy represented the British Crown. Policies under the Viceroy. Lord Canning was the last Governor General and was made the first Viceroy of India. The British stopped conquering Indian states heartlessly. Indian rulers were allowed the right of adoption. Indians were given freedom to practice any religion. They were given high posts in the administration. The Indian army was completely restructured. European forces were increased and the artillery was under the command of the British. Queen Victoria's Proclamation of 1858. On November 1st, 1858, a royal darbar was held at Allahabad. At the meet, Lord Canning read the proclamation issued by Queen Victoria. The proclamation stated that all treaties signed between the company and the Indian princes will be upheld. It guaranteed religious and social freedom to Indians. It stated that most offenders imprisoned during the revolt would be released, except those who were involved in the killing of British officials. The proclamation was called the Magna Carta of India. The Great Revolt of 1857 aroused national feelings and was seen as the starting point of what resulted in India's independence in 1947. The Great Revolt of 1857 brought many Indians to the forefront. Some of them were Bahadur Shah II, Rani Lakshmibai, Begum Hasrat Mahal, Nana Saheb, and Tantya Tope. In this topic, you have learned the main cause for the failure of the revolt was disunity among Indian rulers. The British had better weapons and communication system to suppress the revolt. Queen Victoria's proclamation was issued and the administration of India came directly under the British crown. Many Indian leaders sacrificed their lives during the revolt. The revolt was considered the first war of independence.